the other industries, we don't do that enough. We depend on the walk-in customers, which is going to happen over those 3 days or 4 days of exhibition that we put together. So one thing that we try to do is we have tried to adopt that, integrated that tool into our business practice, where we can help our participating exhibitors set up meetings with their potential customers in advance, so that even before they come to the show, they know that there are going to be meaningful interactions and engagements and businesses there in store. That is one. Second thing is, in the pandemic time, what we did, I'll give you another example. We do this public transport show by the name Pravas. It's scheduled in the month of February in Hyderabad. This year, the first two shows we did in Mumbai. During this entire pandemic time, we conducted seminars for our customers to connect with their customers, who are essentially bus operators. And we took up various interesting topics. It is about finance, it is about maintenance, it is about technology integration and all that. So what happened was, we were constantly in touch with our first customers, but we also made sure that they were talking to their potential customers every now and then, talking about their new product launches and so on and so forth. So I feel that it is not just about those 3 days of engagement. We have to find ways to make sure that the remaining 362 days, whether we can create something by which the dialogue, we help facilitate the dialogue between our exhibitors and their customers. If we can do that, I'm sure loyalty of our customers is nowhere good. Thank you.
Thank you. I often make the statement that the future of exhibitions